World, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. We are here today with a brand new series on MicroPython using a very low cost microcontroller called Pico from Raspberry Pi. So Raspberry, I'm sorry, it's not Pi, but this Pico board, or you can call it as Pico board, it's actually manufactured by Raspberry. And it's a very small, cute looking and very beautiful, yet very powerful. So this particular series, I am going to, you know, show you the integrities and nitty-gritties of Pico. So Raspberry Pi Pico is a low-cost, high-performance microcontroller board with flexible digital interfaces. There are ton loads of digital interfaces. The most important features includes the RP2040 chip, the microcontroller chip, basically, which is like this. You know, this is the main heart of any microcontroller. Probably, you know, you can talk about Arduino, or you can talk about Raspberry Pi, or anything else, right? So this particular 2040 chip is basically a dual core ARM processor, right? And it's got a very powerful flexible running clock of 133 megahertz. The most important thing, Pico board, you know, though it looks very small, but it's, guys, I have built tons of projects on this. I had been doing R&D in the last couple of weeks, and I was able to build so many things. So basically, this Pico board is really good for, you know, IoT projects, mainly for Internet of Things, IoT projects. And also, interestingly, it's for medium to small size robotics projects. So this particular series is for absolute beginners. That is what my intention is, right? Who can learn not just about Pico microcontroller, but also MicroPython. Now, MicroPython, what is it? What exactly is MicroPython? MicroPython is nothing but it's basically a software implementation of a programming language, and which is largely compatible with Python 3, but written on C, okay? Now, the most important aspect of Pico is, we will not only learn MicroPython, but also this works on C++. So ideally, we can use this using Arduino IDE, as well as another IDE, which I'm going to show you in this series for MicroPython coding. So we will learn both C++ as well as MicroPython, okay? And that is pretty much optimized to run on this particular beautiful looking microcontroller. Now, MicroPython is a very tiny open source Python programming language interpreter. You know, it's an interpreter that runs on very small embedded development boards like, you know, Pico and ESP32, ESP8266. I'll be, you know, in the future aspects, I'll be creating multiple videos on ESP32 CAM modules and ESP8266 microcontrollers as well. With MicroPython, you can write a clean and simple Python code to control, you know, the hardware, the MicroPython hardware, that is the Pico, instead of having to use a low level, you know, languages like C or C++, what Arduino uses basically for programming. We will be using a breadboard, guys. You know, it's very easy to connect to multiple components and sensors. And the good part is the Pico comes along with this kind of micro USB cable, same like Arduino Nano. So which is pretty good. The only aspect is you have to do the soldering of this header pins. So if you are good at soldering, you can do that, or else you can get it done from outside. You know, it's up to you. So for this particular series of lessons, you will need a Pico microcontroller board, and I would suggest go ahead and pick up some LEDs, some transistor pull-up resistors, and a few sensor kit. Those who are from the Arduino background, I am sure you might be having bunch of sensors and resistors and LEDs and stuff like that. So I would suggest go ahead and pick up those. And guys, it's very cheap. I paid just about 280 rupees Indian rupees, which is what? Which is just about, I think, $2.50 US, right? The simplicity of Python programming languages makes MicroPython an excellent choice for beginners, especially for the absolute ground zero level beginners who are totally new to programming on any of the microcontroller hardware devices. However, MicroPython is also quite full futuristic and supports most of the Python syntaxes. Even seasoned Python veterans, experienced guys in Python, will find MicroPython familiar and fun to use. You can do ton loads of things. If you have watched my funny Python series, I showed you how to build games, and there are ton loads of gaming programs, right? You can do all those stuff in the Pico microcontroller itself. Now, beyond its ease of use, MicroPython has some unique features that set it apart from other embedded systems. For example, the software libraries, right? Like the normal Python programming language, MicroPython is, you know, is kind of, you know, batteries included. For example, it has libraries to built in to support many tasks. For example, the JSON data, right? The JSON data from the web services, or searching for a text from a regular expression. So all these things is possible. And you can also, MicroPython is also extensible with a low level C, C++ coding functions. So you can mix the expression between MicroPython and the C++ and build your own code. So that it's a pretty interesting, guys. I'm going to show you one at a time how this works. All right. Now let's take a quick look at the architecture of Pico or Pico, however you want to spell it. So basically this has got about 26 multifunctional 3.3 volt GPIO pins. Most important thing, guys, 3.3 volt, it's not a 5 volt, right? And this the Pico board also has two different SPI and two different I2C, two UART and three 12-bit ADC analog to digital converters, and you can see the drawing here. It's got 16 controllable PWM channels. Just imagine the number of sensors and motors we will be able to connect with 16 different PWM channels. And the I2C bus, there are two different I2C bus. So it's kind of, guys, it's really, really powerful. This microcontroller, I am telling you, Pico is going to do ton loads of magic. You are going to see one by one. I am going to walk you through from the scratch to the pretty advanced level. The most important aspect, of course, as I said, the operating voltage for the Pico is just 3.3 volt, and it has 40 GPIO pins, 40 different pins. If you take a look at it, it's got 40 different pins. But it does not share the same form factor as the Raspberry Pis before. You know, of course, the Raspberry Pi is much bigger, and that's a single board computer. It's a SBC. But this is a microcontroller. Pico is a microcontroller. And we have GPIO pins for digital inputs, outputs, pulse width modulation, that is your PWM, and for very specialized communication protocols such as I2C, SPI, UART, you know, and the serial bus. The GPIO has almost about three different analog inputs, something like, you know, similar to Raspberry Pis, but, you know, they definitely lack on all these GPIO pins, which is the big advantages of microcontroller, right? Of course, we'll be using ton loads of, you know, sensors like potentiometer, joysticks, ultrasonic sensors, you know, infrared sensors. I'll be showing you multiple other sensors, guys. I'm going to build multiple projects and show you to you how to build it and program it in MicroPython and make it work. Now, let's also take a look at the board layout. It's very important for you to understand how these pin configurations are done, what these pins are for, right? It's very important before you start building the project, you need to understand each and every pin. So let's take a look at this particular drawing. So as you can see, the 40 IO pins, the input output pins, do not have headers, but have holes to solder the headers activities ourselves, right? So additionally, these 40 pins, basically, let me just switch over to the previous one. You can see all these 40 pins has each in detailed specification of which pin is. The most interesting part is the ground pin, right? There are four this side and four this side. There are eight ground pins. So it's very easy for breadboarding aspects. And if you use the breadboard, it's very easy for us to form the circuits and even on the customized PCB board, right? So it's pretty interesting. Now, if you look at these pins, if you want to design a breakout board using Pico, if you want to design your own PCB board or you know, any kind of custom built board, then you can use these edges to solder the Pico very easily. It's very, very easy. That when you buy, when you open the packet, you don't get the header pins, it's just the holes. So it's very easy to use only the specific pin which you want to use. You don't have to use all the 40 pins for every product, right? You will access only certain amount of pins. So when you are customizing your own PCB board, you just have to solder those points. So it's pretty easy, guys. It's very easy. Another important, and it's slightly disappointing though, is the top of the Pico doesn't have any pin labels. So if you take a look at it carefully, it doesn't come with the numbering, the pin numbering, like how Arduino UNO or any of the other Arduinos or any other microcontrollers, right? They are printed on the bottom of the board. You have to turn it upside down. So this is one painful stuff. Once you use your breadboard or a PCB, you really don't know which pin it is, you know, because you have to remove it again and see it at the bottom. So the best thing is use this drawing side by side. Keep this with you. Or, you know, once you start building the project, all the pin numbers you can easily memorize. Or the easiest way is to count from this side. You know, this is the pin number one from your micro USB, right? If you see in the drawing, that's how the pin configurations are. So that's the only, the negative aspect which I could see. So let's conclude what you can expect to learn from this particular Zero to Hero series on MicroPython using Pico. All right. So basically, I will show you everything from ground zero, from scratch, and that's why this series is called Zero to Hero. We can use the power of Pico at the heart of robotics and any other different types of motorized projects. I'm going to build a couple of small size or medium size robots and any other motor driven projects as well. And also we can collect the data using sensors for temperature, humidity, light, you know, pollution, and we can learn the basics of Python programming using MicroPython and electronics. Moving along, guys, in future, we will build some machine learning projects as well using Pico. So that's going to get really, really, really interesting, right? So you can imagine the power of Pico. You know, it'll lead you towards the machine learning, the micro machine learning, or you can call it as a tiny machine learning. That's what we will, you know, reach in the future lessons. All right, guys, stay tuned, and I hope you will definitely enjoy this particular series. Do go ahead and procure your a Pico kit along with a couple of sensors and stuff like that, and I'll be back soon in the lesson number one. Goodbye.